Here at the University of Tennessee, the number one weed that our team works on is annual bluegrass. In this video, we'll review pre-emergence options for annual bluegrass control in Bermudagrass. So in any research trial, it's important that you have non-treated check plots, and that's what we're looking at here. So this is a plot that received no herbicide treatment, and in all of our research trials, we have multiple replications. So in each replication of the trial, we'll have a non-treated check plot, and then we can compare the performance of our treatments to that non-treated area that serves as sort of a really good relative comparison. We can see in this non-treated check plot, ample weed pressure. We have plenty of Poa annua in several windranial broadleaf weed species as well. I will say that in some of our research efforts here at this site, in Knoxville, we first noticed annual bluegrass emergence on August 5th, and it continued throughout the duration of the fall of 2020. And by the time October concluded, our yearly cumulative emergence was 80%. And knowing that that emergence occurs over a long time domain, it's one of the things that can make pre-emergence control really hard, because for pre-emergence applications to work effectively, they need to be applied before the POA has emerged from the soil. So the plot that we're looking at here, this is Regal Star 2. This is a pre-emergence herbicide. This was applied on August 26th at a rate of 200 pounds per acre. Regal Star 2 is a mixture of oxydiazon and prodiamine, and at the 200 pound spread rate here, delivers 2 pounds of oxydiazon and a little under a half of a pound of prodiamine. And what we can see in the plot is our POA control here has been fairly decent, but we have missed several winter annual broadleaf weeds with this application. So the next treatment is Curb TNO, and this is the SC formulation of Curb. This was applied on August 26th at 40 fluid ounces per acre, pre-emergence timing for annual bluegrass. And much like we saw with our Regal Star 2 treatment here, this has done fairly well for controlling Poa annua pre, but it has missed a handful of winter annual broadleaf species that we can see in the center of the plot. So here we have a newer herbicide. So this is Cru. Cru is a mixture of isoxapin and dithiapyr. Many may be familiar with isoxapin as the active ingredient in Gallery, a herbicide used for pre-emergence broadleaf weed control for a long time. And the dithiapyr is the active ingredient in Dimension, one of our pre-emergence herbicides used regularity for annual weed species, particularly crabgrass. Here we have an application of Cru initiated on August 26th, and then a sequential application was made in December. In both instances, we had 200 pounds per acre applied as a granular carrier, and we can see that our overall control here has done fairly well. We're done a good job keeping Poa annua at bay. We don't see a lot of Poa in the center of this plot, and our overall winter annual broadleaf pressure compared to what we saw in the non-treated has certainly been reduced from these sequential applications of Cru. So there are many pre-emergence control options for Poa annua, much more than what we have evaluated in this experiment. And one of the reasons that this experiment from a pre-perspective has been scaled down is that as UT Extension, we are recommending mixtures of pre- and post-emergence herbicides for Poa annua control in Bermudagrass. And in future videos, we're going to talk about mixture concepts for controlling Poa annua that have performed well in research trials here at the University of Tennessee. I'd like to take a moment to thank multiple groups that have supported the research that you've seen in this video and other videos on Poa annua control from the University of Tennessee. With all of our trial work, everything you've seen in this video has been replicated at other locations across the state. And I'd like to thank all of the superintendents within the Tennessee Golf Course Superintendents Association that have supported that work and been host sites for trials. We really couldn't do it without you, and having multiple locations really gives us more confidence and more power to the results. So thank you to those that have helped with auxiliary sites. I'd like to thank the East Tennessee Research and Education Center, kind of the home to UT Turfgrass Research, for providing us a facility and opportunity to do the bulk of our work that we do in the Turfgrass Weed Science program. I'd also like to thank the Tennessee Turfgrass Association, as well as the Tennessee Valley Sports Turf Managers Association, for their support, not only of this research, but all the research we do within the UT Turfgrass program. And then lastly, I'd like to thank numerous industry supporters, particularly those that have submitted treatments for inclusion in these programs. Having your support to do this work and provide turfgrass managers solutions to this problem of poa annua control in turf is much appreciated. So thank you for that.